Hello and welcome everyone. My name is Manuel Quintana with Pragmatic Works, and in today's video, we're going to take a look at a new Paginated Reports authoring experience. This is going to be through the service. If you remember way back when, they did introduce, and I think for the briefest moment, it even had carried the term operational report. But we got this ability through the Power BI service to create Paginated Reports. In that initial kind of implementation of it, rather simplistic, it could give you possibly some results in a very simple manner. You could filter those results, but some of the things like parameters weren't available to us. We also had pretty limitations on how we could modify and affect things like headers and footers. We have now a whole new experience, an updated experience to how we can generate paginated reports right through the service itself. Pretty cool, pretty awesome. I should say though, if you're looking for that full experience, the full capability, the full customization, of course, you're going to definitely be wanting to get into that Power BI paginated report builder, right? That's the desktop tool. But it's nice to see some of the kind of new introductions and features that now we can find here in the service. And as you're going to see, we're going to be able to do this pretty darn quickly. So before I dive into the service itself, here is this article at the time of this recording, relatively new here, carrying that preview tag. But this is the main article. If you wanted to look it up, check it out. There'll be follow-ups to this, of course, over time. But we're going to see this for ourselves, a new editor experience. We can visibly preview the data as we're moving it. It's very that part starting to really mimic the desktop tool itself. And if you go down, you're going to see some keywords, headers, and footers. You can add some pre-configured text in here. And then also we can see parameters, right? So that's a pretty cool item that we're going to see as well. And you're going to see we can do this pretty darn quickly. So what I'm going to do, head over to Power BI. A couple of ways we can go about this, right? You can go right into the actual data set itself that you're interested in building the report off of. You, of course, can hit the drop down here for new, and you can hit page and report and then point to the data set. But since I'm in my workspace, I'm in a data set. And again, you know, this is in a data set that is made available to you. It's just in my own workspace. You can use this for anything, right? This is just meant to be a primer, a little example. But pick a data set, right, that you already have done with Power BI. You can go in here, right here in the center, you're going to see explore this data. So that's what I'm going to go ahead and do. And we're going to say, I want to create a paginated report. And right away, right off the bat, you see the new UI, right? Compared to what we had before, definitely a nice, fun improvement. Right-hand side, we can see our Power BI model, and we're really just able to start picking and choosing what it is we would like to see. So let's dive in and see some of these new features. So I can go over here, and I'm going to start by doing just a breakdown of like products. Let's do sales by product, right? So I can go over here and grab my, I'm going to grab my English product name. We'll go ahead and grab something like, there's a description. And the best part is as we're adding this in here, right, you can see I can modify and adjust things over here. That description's a bit longer. So I'm going to go ahead and just grab like a model name, and I'm going to go ahead and grab the class, right? And then I'm going to leave this over here because I want to add an aggregation, right? So you can see not much going on with that class itself. I think actually style has a little bit more. So let me go grab that. I think there's more in there. If you also wanted to make adjustments to where this is located, as far as like the order of these items, notice we have this build section right here. I can go ahead and move these around as I see fit. And also kind of similar to like Power BI, you can go in here and double click and modify this. So if I just, you know, instead of English product name, now this is just product name. And the best part is you can see it doesn't affect the underlying name of the column inside the data set. It just affects it on how we're seeing it down below. And if we wanted to add an aggregation, of course, if for me in internet sales, I do have some measures. So I'm just going to go ahead and find my total sales and put that right in there. And you can see it's kind of auto populating. And if we ever have an issue where we kind of go outside the boundaries right here, you're going to see it is visibly represented, right? In the paginated report, this is a problem we commonly have where now that extra item is like spilling over to another page over here, which is not good, right? We want to remedy that. So what I can do is I can simply just bring that in and it'll actively show this adjustment inside the actual preview, and I can make sure that this is all fitting on that one page. Now naturally total sales probably doesn't need to be that long, so I can go ahead and probably shrink that down. If you wanted to, you could move the entirety of this table however you see fit, maybe just not on that left hand side. Just a choice really that we can make for ourselves, just depending on how we want to establish this. Now not everything is here from a parity perspective, like features. We don't have, as you can see, like a horizontal or a vertical centering option here in these various settings above. So I imagine there'll be more to come, but as of right now, you can move some stuff. You can, of course, adjust the column sizes. There are some items you can find over here. It's kind of limited, but you can do the style. You might remember this, where we can do like something like contrast alternating rows. and you can make that adjustment. So it's nice, it's clean, it's simple. If something gets aggregated as well, it's important to note that you can say, hey, you know what, total sales, I need to modify that rather than it being aggregated, or if I want to filter something, let me make those types of adjustments. So if for some reason we needed to go ahead and do an aggregation on style, I could do this. This is a calculated measure, so it's already determined, but do I want to include show totals, right? That's an option right here that we can leverage as well. Cool UI, cool new interface, and let's not forget also we have the ability here of modifying the header, which in the header itself, you can go ahead and add things like images. And that can come from a URL, a file. All you do is make your choice in question, click in the box, and it gives you that choice. So for me, in my downloads, I have a nice little Pragmatic Works logo here that I can just drop right in. I can kind of configure it as I see fit. There are some image options here. You can see for the delay, I can say, you know what, for the display, sorry, I can hit fit to size. You know, and just kind of set it up however I see fit. If we'll get that there, make it tight onto the line, something like that nature. And of course, you can go ahead and add your own like text boxes, same thing. Click on what you're looking for, click in the header, and you can say, this is my sales by product. And of course, there are some options here as far as configuration goes. So I would want to go ahead, stretch this out. I'm going to go ahead and increase the font size, we'll do something a little bit larger, we'll bold it. And let me make it so it fits there in one item, right? You could, of course, do other things, but we don't, once again, I don't have like a background option here for fill. I'm not seeing an option here in regards, you know, I could underline this if I wanted to, sure. But, you know, centering vertically, horizontally. I said, I'm assuming these features will be coming, but it's a nice addition, right? We can see this all right here. That's my header, right? So this is what I'm doing. Do I want to show it on the first page, last page? You can add some things in here. Usually we wouldn't put this in the header, but that's the cool part, right? I can go in and say, you know what? Let me also add a footer in here. And as part of the footer, I will lean on these default fields. So I can get my page number and I can decide where that needs to be. So I can go ahead and just drag this. And let's say I want to put it kind of in the middle bottom, you know, kind of somewhere around there. I can check out my preview down below. And there's my right there. This would also be where it'd be good to have like smart lines or, you know, the pixel, like the location, X, Y location. So we can kind of really center this down. I'm assuming that will come in time too. And we also saw that I could add in, if you wanted to, the execution time. Usually throw that like in the bottom right corner. And once again, we get a preview. As we are doing this, we're seeing the preview, right? So there's my pages. I can go to the next page, so on and so forth. And let's not forget the last piece of this puzzle that's definitely something that people have been eyeing up and waiting for, right? I'll probably go ahead and increase that just a little bit, is parameters, right? So when we talk about those parameters, of course, you can go here to, now this is the fill, it's important. This is the build area, which is going to show up in the actual table itself. And then you have the filter section. Naturally, any of the categorical fields that are part of the report show up in this filters area. But you can actually add things specifically in here. So for instance, and you can, this is where you create parameters. Normally you can go in here and literally, this is what we saw before. You can just use this for filtering purposes. But now if a field exists here, for instance, like for product, for color, I can drag that in. And instead of just having this like drop-down filter capability, I can present something to the user to control. And it tells us, I'm going to create a parameter. It says, hey, viewers will be able to apply it to the report. So the filter section, as an admin or someone in the workspace who can modify this object, I can do the filters and just kind of set it for the report. But if I want my users to be in charge of this, I can just change it to a parameter. It'll appear for the user right here at the top. You can see it's right there and they can make their own choices. You know, I only want to see the red products. Hit view report and then you can preview it down here below and you can see the various items. Not a lot of red products, but it's in there, right? This is working. This is doing exactly what it needs to do. So definitely something I know I was really craving, having that parameter capability. So it's nice that it is in here. And I imagine that the feature set and capability is only going to continue to grow. So I really like the update. I like the changes for you know, having some simple operational reports here. I think this is going to serve a really nice purpose. But once again, if you really want to dive in to the expression language, get in there and start using some of the SSRS expression language, making things more dynamic, you're going to have to go to the desktop tool. But with that being said, I can go ahead, just save this, put it in the same workspace that I'm in. Paginated report. Got to spell it. Well, we don't have to spell it right. I will for the sake of this, right? And now inside this workspace, we've got Paginated Report. You know, I might have actually just saved that elsewhere. That's all right. But that's how, you know, of course, we can get in there. There it is, Paginated Report. It's there. It's available. Technically, you can go through, and now it's just like a normal Paginated Report that you can do whatever you'd like to do with, right? So that's the idea here, right? And just extension. It was nice to see that the Paginated Report, to be able to create it through the service, became an option in the first place, but it was rather rudimentary. And with this kind of, I'll call it like a little facelift, we definitely have more of the features that we were expecting. And then, as I imagine, this is just my own conjecture, right? That we'll see some additional things come into the future. But I think that's the idea, is to, if we're looking to create a very simple operational report like this, now we have that option built right here into the service. And if you are looking to be a little more customized, if you want to customize your report a little bit more, we of course have the Power BI Report Builder tool that we can leverage, which we have other videos around that that you can check out. But really excited when I saw this change. I think it's a great one. Hopefully you do too. And enjoy checking out this new UI for creating Paginated Reports in the service. As always, I hope you enjoyed. And of course, subscribe if you haven't already. I'll see you in the next one.